Now, the 15th of January every year is a day set aside by government to honor Nigeria's fallen heroes, those who paid the supreme price to keep the country safe and won. Now, to that end, officials of government in all the states and at the federal level abandoned their normal schedules to pay respect to these soldiers. Our correspondents filed these reports.
The conflict in the northeast of Nigeria and other troubled regions have left many wives of military officers widowed. Despite the many deficits suffered in the nation's military, these soldiers leave their families behind for the battlefield to face unrepentant militants. While some were lucky to return to their families, others never did. Here in Lagos, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu joined others to pay respect to the fallen heroes with an assurance to the widows and other members of the families that they will not be forgotten.
You saw me taking pictures with the wives of the current officers. We also can extract information from them so that we make it targeted. You know, I don't need to begin to explain what I've done in the last couple of months. But we also make sure that in our next program, we deliberately look for all of the widows of our fallen hero and we give them empowerment, because that's truly, really what they will require. You know, for government to be able to give them a social empowerment where they can continue to fend for their families and themselves.
The heroes were on Wednesday honored for their sacrifices and bravery, responsible for the peace and unity enjoyed today. A security expert who spoke during STV News Breakfast Show News Hub appealed to government at all levels to, rather than pay lip service to the plight of Nigerian soldiers, walk the talk.
We are celebrating today. I want the presidency to hear me out. We need to start investing in military hardware and software. It was a software that was used to eliminate Soleimani. Without anybody manning it. Why? Because the American believe in the survival of his men. We shouldn't be losing men in the front line. We should invest in technology. That is one. Then secondly, we also need to look at our border security. It's very, very essential, because when you look to the left, from the east, west, south and north, we are bordered by Cameroon from the south, bordered by Niger from the north, bordered by Chad, bordered by Benin Republic. These five countries that surrounds us are all Francophone speaking countries. We are the only Anglophone speaking country. That alone is a natural threat on its own.
Laina Reed and selected government officials in honor of the departed and inspection of Guard of Honor were other activities to mark the day. From Lagos, Victor Mbadike, STV News.
The armed